Okay, next numerical integration technique I will try to explain is Simpson's rule. I guess Simpson created it. Okay. Okay, so what happens here is, again, if we have any general function y equals f of x, okay, again, it's okay to be negative, and we want to find the definite integral from a to b of f of x dx, and just like the trapezoidal rule, let's just make our lives simple by making the intervals regular, okay?
Yes.
So we have a regular partition, so the intervals have equal length, okay, which we call h. So again, the usual formula for finding h is the right endpoint minus the left endpoint divided by the number of subintervals you want to use, okay? Now, for trapezoidal rule, what we said was we approximated the curve by a line, right?
Yes.
Now, for Simpson's rule, what we want to do is we want to approximate the curve by a parabola, segments of parabolas. Now, in order to use parabolas, we have to actually consider two subintervals.
Yes.
Okay, two adjacent subintervals. And I'll try my best to draw the parabola. So, for instance, here are the 3 points we have, right?
Yes.
Connected by this curve. We will try to find the best approximation for this using a parabolic function.
Yes.
Right? Meaning a quadratic function, okay, that will graph as a parabola. I won't attempt to draw the others, but really what you want is to draw tiny parabolas for two subintervals.
Yes.
Okay? So imagine now this is that I did a good job, okay, drawing my parabolic arc. Okay?
Yes.
So then what I will do is, of course, it boils down to finding what? The area,
yes.
The area under this curve, right? The parabolic curve, the red curve over here, right?
Yes.
From x sub 0 to x sub 2.
Yes.
You follow?
Yes.
Okay? And you will agree with me that that's not obvious what that is, right?
Yeah.
Like earlier, we said, for a rectangle, it was easy, length times width, right?
Yes.
For a trapezoid, it was easy. It's b1 plus b2 divided by 2 times h, right?
Yes.
But now you have, you're here and you say, oops, so what is that?
Yes.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
So we want to find that. So in general, we can call this parabolic graph, let's say y equals ax squared plus bx plus c.
Let's see.
Correct?
Yes.
Correct? That's the general form.
General form of the problem.
For a quadratic function.
Yes.
Okay? And let's see. So what's the story here? We want over these two subintervals, this subinterval is length h.
Yes.
This subinterval is length h. So in order to simplify our problem, at least this is one thing I saw some books do. I think Sokowski did it this way, is let's look at this arc. We don't even know where the origin is, right? So let's put it here so that make this, so this piece is what I'm looking at, right?
Okay. Yes.
Move this so that I have here a negative h and an h. Is that clear?
Yes.
Why? Okay. So I'm just going to be interested now in finding the area bounded by this parabola, okay, under this parabola from negative h to h. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. And, of course, you agree that we can easily set it up, right? How do we set this area up? What do we do? How do we find this area, Reza?
So to find this area, we can use
it's just what?
Integration.
Integration, right? Okay.
Yes.
So it's just the integral from?
From minus h
minus
to positive h.
H. And don't use symmetry because I don't really know where this parabola is.
Yes.
It's a segment of a parabola, okay? Ax squared plus bx plus c.
Yes.
Times dx.
Dx.
Okay? Let me do that over here. So we want to find the area of that piece, okay? So you have ax squared plus bx plus c dx. A, b, and c are just constants.
Constant.
Right? And what do we have? We can integrate this with respect to x,
x.
Easily, right?
Yes.
Okay, the integral of ax squared is what?
A 1/3 x to the cube.
Where should I usually use like this.
Exactly.
Okay, right?
Yes.
A x cubed over 3 plus bx one squared over 2 plus
cx.
Cx evaluated from
negative h to h.
Okay?
Yes.
So then what I have is, if I plug in h, I have ah cubed over 3 plus bh squared over 2 plus ch. That's the upper limit, right?
Yes.
The upper limit.
Minus.
The lower limit is a times negative h, should I fix? Well, let's worry about the signs later. Plus b negative h squared over 2 plus c times negative h.
Yes.
So far okay?
That's right.
All right. So let's see what we'll get here. This is going to be a negative, right? With a negative will be a what? Negative and negative will be a?
Is a positive.
Positive. So yes. That's positive a h cubed over 3, which will can combine with this, correct?
Yes.
Okay? So therefore you'll have
2a
h cubed over 3. Right?
Yes.
Now this is just going to be positive.
Positive.
Right? Yes. But there's a minus outside.
It's negative.
So that's minus bh squared over 2 with a plus bh squared over
cancel
2.
Cancel out.
Happens, these guys will disappear,
yes.
Right? Okay? And this is a minus ch with a minus there will become what?
Positive.
Plus ch plus another
positive.
Ch.
It's 2ch.
So you have a 2ch.
Yes.
Okay? So far that's what we have. What is this again?
Actually, this is the area under
the... Yeah, this is just the area under one thing, right?
Yes.
Okay? From negative,
negative
h to
h.
All right. Okay, let's breathe. Okay, so right now we said we just got this, right? In terms of a and c and b disappeared, okay?
Yes.
But our goal is now to be able to find a, b, and c in terms of our function,
yes.
Right? Because if we are going to use this numerical integration, you're already guessing, well, I have to use f somehow, right?
Yes.
And so far, f is not here at all yet, okay?
Yes.
So that's what we're going to try to do. Maybe I'll blow it up here. Okay, let's see. So I kind of draw it symmetric, but it's not. All right, so here?
Yes.
We actually are looking, if you remember when I first started talking about this, I was really looking at these 3 points, right?
Yes.
Okay? So I actually have 3 points on the parabola that I can use, okay?
Yes.
And what are the coordinates of those 3 points? So I have this, this, and this.
Yes.
Okay? Can you give me one?
So the first one, the x is negative h.
The first one, the x is negative h.
And to get the y, we plug in negative h into the function.
Mm-hmm. So it's just f of negative h.
F of
right?
Negative h.
Okay. It's f of negative h. Okay, again, let's see, which is confusing. Maybe I should do it here.
Here, okay.
Okay?
Yes.
So I have these 3 points, right? Remember I said I just did this trick just to make my life easier when
yes.
I set up my definite integral to find the area. It was really from this section, right?
Yes.
These first two things here from x sub 0, x sub 1, and x sub 2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yes.
So really, yeah, the first coordinate here is negative h, right? But it corresponds to this height, which is this height here corresponding to x sub 0,
yes.
Right? So if you wish, you can call it f of x sub 0, but to make our notation shorter, I can just call it y sub 0.
Yes.
Okay? So I have negative h, y sub 0, that's the first y corresponding to x sub 0, okay?
Yes.
All right, this one, again I move things around, so now this coordinate here will be 0, right? But the height will be the same as this height over here. Is it okay?
Yes.
I'm not confusing you, all right?
That's right.
And this height is the value of the function at x
at
sub 1,
x1.
Right?
Yes.
Instead of calling it f of x sub 1, I'll call it y sub 1.
Y1.
Okay?
Yes. Yes.
All right?
That's right.
Finally, this point was really that point. You know, it did a good job. Okay? They don't look the same. Okay, this point was really that point, right?
Yes.
So therefore, these coordinates will be what? The coordinates will be h, right?
Yes.
But the height is going to be the value of the function at x sub 2, right?
Yes.
Rather than calling it f of x sub 2, let's call it
y sub 2,
just so it's not too crowded. It's already crowded.
Yes.
Did I confuse you? Or
no,
okay?
That's clear.
Okay. So here you have, let's go back here. So you have negative h, y sub 0, 0, y sub 1, h, y sub 2. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So why do I want those 3 points? Remember my goal was to find a, b, and c.
That's right.
Right. We are hoping that we can express a, b, and c in terms of our function, in terms of the y's of the function.
Yes.
Okay. So, because these 3 points are on the parabola, what's the equation of the parabola?
Y equals ax
squared
plus
bx
plus c.
If we use these 3 points, what are we going to produce? So if we put negative hy0, the first point,
yes.
right? That means to say when x is negative h, I have y sub 0, right?
Y0 so equals.
Equation, y sub 0 is equal to h squared. Negative h squared is
yes.
h squared, right?
Minus bh.
Minus bh, because that's b times negative h.
Plus
correct?
C. Yes.
Plus c. So far, okay?
Yes.
And then you also use the second point, 0, y1, all right?
Yes.
That means to say when you substitute 0 for x, you get y, is y1.
Y1.
And when you put 0 for
zero.
X, you just get c, right?
Yes.
Okay? And then you have h, y sub 2, the third point. That means to say y sub 2 is the answer for y when x is h,
yes.
right? So you have ah squared plus bh plus c.
Yes.
In other words, the three points will give us three equations in three unknowns, a, b, c.
Yes.
And we should be in business, right?
That's
we
right.
We know what A, B, and C are.
Or.
We should be able to figure them out.
Exactly.
In fact, I see one of them already. What's one of them that I see?
Y1 equals C.
I see that C is equal to Y1.
Y1.
Right?
Yes.
So if C is equal to Y1, I can replace C by Y1,
Y1.
Here in this. Okay? So I'll get Y sub 0 minus Y1 is equal to AH squared minus BH. Did
yes.
you understand where this came from?
Yes.
Yeah, I just threw this C
exactly.
over here. Okay? Again, if I replace C by Y1, I get Y sub 2 minus Y1 is equal to AH squared plus BH. Clear?
Yes.
Why am I excited about this?
Now we are looking for A and B.
I have to solve for A and B, but can I do that?
Actually, now we have this situation.
I have two equations in the two unknowns, A and B.
Yeah,
right?
It is possible.
And there's a nice thing I can do with these two equations. What's that nice thing I can do with the equation?
Substitution.
Is it substitution? I see a
or
better one.
I can see elimination.
Well, both are elimination methods. Either you substitute or the easiest thing to do is simply to what?
To add them.
To add, right?
Yes.
See, if you add the equations, what do you get? Over here, you'll have y sub 0 minus 2y sub 1 plus y sub 2, right?
Yes.
Correct? And on the right side, what happens? Somebody will disappear. Who will disappear?
BH.
BH, right? Okay. So you'll have AH squared how many times?
Two times.
2 times. Okay?
Yes.
So you have 2AH squared is y sub 0 minus 2y1 plus y sub 2.
Yes.
Okay. And then, so now, how does that help me?
So here we can find A.
Yeah, okay. I'm thinking now, yeah, Reza said we can isolate A and then get the B and so on and so forth. But let's go back to what I was looking at earlier over here.
Yes.
This was the area of, how do I label this? This is the area of the first set, right?
Yes.
Okay. And this is the expression that I got, okay? So that is what I want to try and figure out how to write in terms of those, the y's.
Yes.
All right? So let's go back to this. So I want this A of the first parabolic section, right? To
yes.
To be equal to 2A, that's 2A h cubed over 3 plus 2CH.
Yes.
Okay? Notice that I can, because I see a 2A h squared there, right?
Yes.
And that's why I'm saying, okay, I think that's all I need now, and I should be in business pretty soon, okay?
Yes.
I'll do a trick here, not mine, it's all in the book, okay? You can take out an h over 3.
Yes.
Okay? I need a 2's, correct? Okay, if I take out the h over 3, what happens to the first term?
So h over 3 is a 2ah squared.
2ah squared. I'm happy, right?
Yes.
Because I have 2ah squared here.
Yes.
Now, if I factor out an h over 3, what happens to the 2c? Notice I factored out the 3, so the 2 has to become what? What number?
6.
6, okay? So that will be a 6c. Is that yeah. correct?
Yes.
Okay. Why am I happy? Why am I saying, Oresa, I don't really need to solve for a and b completely? Again, if you look at this, I already have this expression for 2ah squared, right?
Yes.
That I can put here, correct?
Yes.
Also, I already have c that I can put here.
Yes.
Right? And that's all I want because function, the values of the function and the numbers. Okay?
Yes.
So let's clean this up. If you use those, you ready to move?
Yes.
We have the area of the first parabolic, maybe I can call it parabolic sector, I'm not making it up. We look like 2a squared will be this, right? So let's see, I'll have y sub 0 minus 2y1 plus y2. You understand?
Yes.
That's your 2ah squared. Plus 6c, but c is y1, so you have 6y1. Okay?
Yes.
And now if we clean this up, we'll get h over 3 times what? Y sub 0.
Yes.
Minus 2y1 plus 6y1 is?
4y1.
Plus 4y1, right?
Plus y2.
Plus y2. Okay? All right?
Yes.
So what have we done so far? Okay, let's go back to the picture over here. Let me get my eraser. I think it's getting very crowded. So again, I just used this trick to figure this area, right?
Yes.
Figure out what this area is. So you understand this, I'll erase this.
Yes,
okay?
Yes.
Okay. So I found out from the deriving over there that what? The area of this entire thing, right?
Yes.
Under this parabola is, can you dictate, Teresa? I think it's h over 3,
h
right?
Over 3.
Y sub 0
y plus,
0 plus
4y1 plus
y2.
Y2? Yes.
Right. So that's for these two, correct?
Yes.
Now I do the same thing for the next two.
Yes.
And it's going to be the same story,
same.
Right? Same derivation, same story. So for this next two, I will get what? The first one is what? So it's h over 3 again, but the first one corresponds now to x2, so that's going to be y2. You follow?
y2, yes.
That's the first one, right?
Yes.
y2.
Yes.
The next one will be
4 y3.
y3. And then this one will be?
y4.
y4. Do you see what's happening?
Yes.
All right? So this will keep repeating for every pair, right?
Yes.
So actually, I did not point that out earlier because for Simpson's rule, we're using pairs. We cannot really just make any n, right?
Yes.
What should n be? Because we're using them two at a time.
2 by 2, so n is 2.
We want n to be even.
Even,
right?
Yes.
But we cannot have n equals 7 because we will leave out somebody.
Exactly.
We need a pair.
Pair.
Okay?
Yes.
Now, hopefully you can already see that there's a pattern here, right?
Yes.
The pattern, and that's what you were telling me earlier. Oh, Simpson's rule, I remember, is that 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2.
Yes.
Right? You see the 4, 2, 4, 2 now?
Exactly.
This, the first one is 1, doesn't get repeated, right?
Yes.
There's a 4, never happens again.
Yes.
Correct? The y2 and the y2 is there, so two of them.
There is a 2.
Right?
Yes.
And then a 4 again for the y3.
Yes.
Okay, and then this y4 will be repeated in the next, one. You understand?
Yes.
All right? So that's how Simpson's rule works. So if you know this, actually you should be in business because, you know, for the most part, the exercises will just involve, like, you know, a finite number, like n equals 5. No, not 5. Made a mistake right there. Okay, n equals 6, right?
Exactly.
N equals 6, 8, and so on and so forth.
Yes.
Is that okay, or do you want me to write it nicer? Okay, Reza's not happy with this. We should give the ending. How will this story end? Yeah, because I guess you're worried, well, where will the 1, 4, 1, 4, 2, and so on and so forth end, right?
Yes.
So if we were to write this, actually, what will be the formula for the approximation? And some books use S for Simpson.
Yes.
Okay? S, which is going to be the approximation for the definite integral a to b of f of x dx,
yes.
Right? That's the story.
Yes.
Is h over 3, let's see what it will look like. Y sub 0, you said, is going to be y sub 0
y
forever,
zero.
Right?
Yeah, that's right.
There will be a 4 y sub 1, which will never happen again,
yes.
Correct?
That's right.
And then there's a y sub 2, which happened again here.
So 2.
It, right? So there will be 2 of them.
Yes.
And then the 4 y sub 3 you'll never see again also, right?
That's right.
But this y sub 4 you'll see in the next one.
Yes.
Right? So that will be 2 y sub 4. Plus and so on, what do you think will happen? We're actually looking at the last two here, right? This is x sub n. This is x sub n minus 1. This is x sub n minus 2.
Yes.
Correct? And of course, the answers we're looking at are y sub n minus 2, y sub n minus 1, y sub n, right?
Yes.
Those are the heights or the values of the functions that we want. So if we continue this over here, so you'll have an h over 3, right?
Yes.
Y sub n minus 2 plus 4, y sub n minus 1, isn't it?
Yes.
Because we're taking pairs, so it's the same story for this last pair. Follow?
Yes.
Okay. So we know that if we want to look at the tail end, this guy, y sub n minus 2, was here in the previous one, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So you'll have 2 y sub n minus 2, right?
Yes.
And then you have a 4 y sub n minus 1. And then the last one is y sub
n.
So the pattern is, yeah, it's 4, 1, 4, and then 4, 1 at the end.
Yes.
Okay, and then you just have the 2, 4, 2, 4
yes.
in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
That's right.
So maybe we're ready to look at an example. Alright, so we have the integral from 0 to 1 of 5x to the 4th dx, n equals 4. Actually, you don't really need to graph the function, right? Because we said it can be anywhere. It could be above, below, and so on and so forth. So we just look at our interval 0 to 1. And what we want to do is to divide it into four
sections.
Sub-intervals, right? So again, if you look at h, h could be what? It's going to be
one
the right
minus
endpoint
zero.
Minus the left divided
over
by 4.
Four.
So
1 over 4.
Right?
Yes.
Okay? So we divide this into 4. So then you can figure out what these guys are, right?
Yes.
I'm okay, right?
Yeah.
So that's what you have. Again, I would recommend a chart. So put all your x's here. If you want, you can have a previous column K. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess this is just to convince you that you got all four.
Yes.
Okay? The four sub-intervals. And then this is a half, 3 quarters, and 1. Okay?
Yes.
And then we need to get our f of x, x's. So we just what we do is we just substitute x here, right?
Yes.
F of x is 5x to the 4th. So when you substitute 0, you get 0. When you substitute 1 for it, and let me just copy what I have here from
yes.
the time. So I will get 5 over 256, correct?
Yes.
80 over 256 when I substitute a half. Actually, what this book does is to substitute 2/4. Again, for the benefit of those who are going to use...
Same denominator,
okay?
Yes.
And this is going to be 405 over 256, and this is 5. A lot
yes.
of numbers, okay?
Yes.
Just like what I did for the trapezoidal rule, we can put a column M. Those are the multipliers. Okay? So for Simpsons, the multipliers are what? The first
one
is 1.
4.
The second one is 4.
2.
The last one is?
Again, 1.
1. And the second to the last is?
Is 4 again.
Right?
Yes.
And then that leaves us only one spot that should get a?
2.
2. That's how I remember it, one way you can do it,
exactly,
right?
Yeah.
First and second, last, and the second to the last.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay? And then you do your 4-2, 4-2s.
Yes.
Okay, well, this is a short example, so we're done with that. And then do your m times f of x, okay? And let me just copy what I have here. So this is 0. This is going to be 20 over 256 for those of you who like fractions, okay?
Yes.
160 over 256. 1620 over 256 and 5. You add this as fractions, but again, much as I prefer fractions to decimals, I think for this type of problem, I think it's better because you have your calculators to just use your decimals.
Yes.
I hope I did it right. For Reza, you did it right. Okay?
Yes.
So I converted to decimals and the sum I got, so you add this up, just like for trapezoidal rule, right?
Yes.
You get 12.03125. Now this sum is the sum over here. Can we put it here? Sorry, from the right?
Yes.
So this was what I got. This is the sum. And then Simpson's rule says multiply that sum by
h over 3,
a third of h. H is 1/4, so therefore h over 3, which is a third of h, is 1/3 times 1/4.
1 over 12.
Which is 1/12. Okay?
Yes.
So therefore, if you want the approximation for the definite integral that is around what? 1/12 of 12.03125, okay?
Yes.
And the answer is 1.0026.
Yes.
Okay, zero. Okay?
Yes.
And this is easy enough to evaluate. If you want to get the exact answer, this is 5x. Actually, it's x to the fifth, right?
Yes.
Okay. Evaluated from 0 to 1, and that's just 1 to the fifth minus 0 to the fifth, which is 1.
Yes.
The actual answer is 1.
1.
Approximation was 1.00.
Very close.
Very close. Okay? Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.